Amore.
Subito.
The all-new Fiat 500X crossover.
Ooh.
Bigger, more powerful, and ready for action.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome head of the Fiat brand, Olivier Francois.
Good morning, everyone. So I know this is a fun video, but I'm not showing it for entertainment value. I'm sharing it because what we need to extend here and now is Fiat's reach in North America. It won't take a blue pill, no. It will just take more work, more hard work, some other great Fiats, and also all the commitments of the North American team under my friend Tim Koniskis. I realize that today we are almost exactly 5 years to the day of the reintroduction of Fiat to this market. Yes, we started Fiat literally here in LA in 2010 on this stage. But you know, at the time to launch a brand, all we had really was a speech. I mean, we had no brand presence. The small car segment was a micro segment, 0.05 of the industry. We had no network, zero dealers, and zero customers too. When you have no car park to sell to, you need 100% conquest. But we went from a speech to a brand in record time, and here we are, 5 years later, over 200,000 units sold and over 200 stores. And as you can see on the slide, the GFK research tells us the awareness is up 76%. Our consideration is up 20%, and 95% of our sales are conquest. And Fiat has the highest level of perception in the industry. I mean, in America, the people who drive a Fiat are incredibly proud of their little car. So don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that we can't sell more cars. And my purpose today is pretty much the opposite. It's all about the blue pill. It's about adding excitement. But what we are saying here is that at least the cars we sold for the right reasons. Look at what our buyer says about Fiat. It stands out, it's essential to my life, it's pure Italian driving experience. You know, looking back at 2010, I really think that the last thing the American market needed was another nameplate, another brand. Seriously, there were 41 brands and 290 nameplates in the market space. Showing up with another brand in such a crowded market is probably not enough. You have to have a purpose. No brand can succeed without a purpose, a reason why, something distinctive. And good thing, the consumer discovered very quickly that Fiat is exactly that. It is the furthest thing to another brand. It embodies an experience that could not be found in the market before. The Italian driving experience, the freedom of expressing yourself, the style that only Italy can deliver. It definitely has a purpose. The customers love our Fiats, but what I love even more is that in the past 5 years, we've been seeding a positive message also for the non-customers. I listen to the people in the street, the non-owners, even the immigration officer at the Detroit airport, my weekly barometer of the brand perception. They do like us. They remember our commercials. They enjoy seeing our little Fiat. They connect. And I look at you today, I look at the audience, and I'm humbled to see such an interest. Look, on YouTube last year, our 500X presentation gathered over 500,000 views. 500,000, I mentioned a number because that's not a traditional product reveal number. That's way more than our fair share of attention. I mean, people are drawn to the brand regardless of whether they are in the market for a small car. So, why that? Take it from a Frenchman. I think that every American has a dormant Italian gene. And what does Fiat? It brings it to life. It activates it. So I know it's a fun slide, but the Italian gene is not just about bringing more fun to the auto show. No, it's about bringing something more unique. It's about providing exclusivity and accessibility at the same time. And as a matter of fact, in the $15,000 to say $30,000 price range, not many cars offer passion, even as an option. You'll find attainable toasters, but you won't find much exclusivity. Well, Fiat proves that exclusivity isn't reserved for those with an open checkbook. The moment you step in, it makes you stand out. So let me ask you, can a humble brand make a big statement about who drives it? Fiat does that. I like the idea that some brands have this little supplement of soul, a special DNA, a special way to be special, to be part of something, to be relevant. So we brought to the stage, or to the stand, sorry, two examples of how Fiat is starting to blend into the most iconic pieces of American fabric. Fashion on one hand, entertainment on the other. On the fashion side, I'm proud of our collaboration with Diane von Fürstenberg. Diane is an amazing ambassador for the brand, and for today, Diane chose to wrap a plus-sized model, our 500X. On the entertainment side, you can't be in LA without a nod to Hollywood. That's why you see this very unique Stormtrooper-inspired 500 Electric, crafted by my friend Lapo from Garage Italia in a galaxy far, far away, Milan. Well, it's as electric as a toaster, but at the same time, it is as unique and aspirational as it gets. And this is the whole point. On one hand, you have toasters, a sea of sameness, commodities, affordable commodities. On the other, you have the aspirational offer. It does make you stand out, but you have to pay a premium to get it. So between these two extremes, where is Fiat? Here you are, right in the middle, between affordable and aspirational. Because more than affordable, more than just aspirational, Fiat is simply inspirational.
It doesn't take much to be happy. When you enjoy the simplest and truest things, asking for nothing more than what you've got. Look at your swimming pools. They'll never be enough. Like your fancy watches and your big cars, one day you realize that what matters is not the size of your car. It's the size of your yacht. Because I'm happy. Clap along
if you feel like a room without. Well, as you heard in the commercial, last year's tune and keyword for Fiat was happy. This is why we joined hands with Mr. Pharrell Williams in the first place. But let's face it, for us, happiness is in the numbers. And in order to reach higher numbers, we need to take Fiat to a bigger market space. We need to expand the customer base to customers who need bigger, who need more capable, who need more all weather. So what do? You take the codes of a legendary American, Italian design, and you translate it into American. You take everything you like about your grande, and you make it a venti. Well, we call it 500X. It's bigger, more capable, and all weather. I insist on all weather because there is no doubt. In the Smile States, Fiat is now well established. 74% of our sales today come from the South. So the most logical way to expand our reach is to take on the rest of the country, to take on winter, to take on the snow. I mean, if you are in, say, Minnesota, as much as you like our little Fiats, you may not be comfortable driving a 500 all year long. It's a fact. But now you can definitely drive a 500X. If you are in the mountains, say Denver, as much as you love your Fiat, you were forced to drive a Subaru. So now I give you the X, a perfect Fiat for a snowbelt.
Fiat 500X crossover with available all-wheel drive makes six more weeks of winter pretty appealing.
That's Percutone Filippo, and he's screaming to get your attention because our all-wheel drive is a big deal for 500X. It is not only super capable, it also delivers the fuel economy you expect from a Fiat, thanks to the disconnecting rear axle. And whether it's on the snow or not, 500X is one of the safest vehicles on the road, any season. Look, 500X is the only one in its class with IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus, the only one in its class with over 70 safety features, including some you wouldn't expect in a car like this. Forward Collision Warning Plus, blind spot monitoring, and lane sense departure warning. Oh, I know, I'm pretty much sounding like a traditional car salesman with a list of vehicle features and benefits. But while we have a passion for the substance of a 500X, we must remember that it's a Fiat. It also speaks to style. It's an icon. So we decided to ask one of the most famous models in the world to take it for a test drive. So we didn't hire a model from Victoria's Secret. The wings couldn't fit. We didn't ask a swimsuit model too skimpy. We didn't hire Heidi Klum, too German. So let's discover together who's left.
The Fiat 500X. The perfect fashion accessory to complement any look, even blue steel.
I know. I was driving while hot.
Make every week feel like Fashion Week.
Honestly, I think the work speaks for itself.
Thank you. So no, we're not going to offer a blue steel edition of a 500X, but Derek Zoolander will strike a pose with our Fiat in the upcoming sequel, which after all makes sense because as a category, the small crossovers are definitely in fashion. And 500X, since last month, is at the top of the pack with growth month over month of 91%. So the 500X doesn't just add a blue pill to our numbers. It takes the happiness from the original 500 design and adds some freedom. I mean the freedom to wander, the freedom to roam, the freedom to feel. This is a very Fiat approach to freedom. But there is another Fiat connotation for freedom, the open road and the open air, the Italian art of driving, a road that takes you from a place to a state of mind. It's almost a cliche, I know, but it is one we all like. Open air, a smile on your face, the note of an unmistakable engine in your ear. And automatically, another iconic Fiat from the 60s comes to mind, the 124 Spider. For the US, it is even more iconic than the 500 itself, with over 170,000 sold in America and still today, 8,000 on the roads. So what made 124 such an icon? First, it was an attainable rear-wheel drive roadster, but not any roadster. This one had an incredible design from Pininfarina's legendary Tom Jorda. Back in the days, the master mixed two projects. The front came from Ferrari GTS 1964. And the back came from, incredible but true, from America. It was originally designed for the Corvette 1963 Rondinet prototype. The two inspirations merged in harmony in 1966, and a legend was born. So next year, 2016, marks the 50th anniversary of the icon. But for us, for Fiat, it will mark something even more important. It will mark our return to the open-air market. From the top down, it will deliver more than style, more than performance, more than even 50 years of history. It will deliver, in a very Fiat fashion, a blast of freedom. Welcome the 2017 Fiat 124 Spider. The icon is all new, but the spirit, the one from the vintage Spider on the wall, never left. Refined features, Italian charm, and a blast to drive, both fun and confident. The iconic design is here. It's in front of you, and it's respectful of its Italian heritage, because in Italy, we think that performance is nothing without style. But more importantly, this car, like every new Fiat, is all about substance. First of all, when you drive a Spider, it's about the fun to drive experience. So how does Fiat bring even more fun to an already fun party? It starts with the winning formula of the 60s. Rear-wheel drive, great power-to-weight ratio, short throw shifting, and the wind in your California hair. Our new Spider takes everything that makes a convertible visceral and exciting and dials it up. How? It starts with some venom, a turbocharged 1.4-liter multi-air engine with 184 pound-feet of torque and 160 horsepower. An engine built in Italy, that's the heart of the Spider. And make no mistake, this engine comes standard on all price classes. This is an engine you are already familiar with from the 500 Abarth. So the technology is definitely proven. For the 124, it is paired with a 6-speed manual or automatic transmission, a double wishbone front suspension, and multi-link rear suspension. You know, it's not a dream, it just drives like one. The dream part here was to bring together fun and confidence. You're an average driver, well, you'll feel totally confident and empowered. But if you are a good driver, you will unleash your inner Andretti. So while the Fiat 124 is all about respect, respect for the heritage, it also pays respect to its driver. It has authentic Italian craftsmanship, attention to detail, and quality. Let me quickly walk you through the cabin. So here's what you will easily notice. Unique, tailor-made sport seats, leatherette wrapped IP with soft touch materials, and premium looking black piano accents. An available Fiat Connect 7.0 featuring a 7-inch TFT, navigation, and Pandora radio capability. And the beauty is you can enjoy the great sound whether the top is up thanks to the 9-speaker Bose premium sound system, or down thanks to the dual headrest speakers. So all this is visible at the first glance. But let me ask you, what is the most visible feature in a convertible? The top, obviously. Well, our Spider gives you the quickest and easiest top to operate. Look at this. You can literally go topless with a flick of the wrist. But the best surprise is what you don't see. An incredibly quiet cabin, thanks to an acoustic front windshield, added instrument panel insulation, and thickness of the rear glass. The 124 Spider will give you the quietest cabin in its class. We also have made a massive commitment to safety. This is a car that will be sold to a wide variety of consumers. All will, as we said before, unleash their inner Andretti. But let's face it, not all are seasoned drivers. That's why safety is as big of a deal as it was for 500X. You get rear cross path detection, blind spot monitoring, a ParkView rear camera with grid lines, and much more. It all comes down to engineering, craftsmanship, and conviction. It screams substance to the touch and whispers a quiet confidence to the driver. The Fiat 124 is the quintessential fun-to-drive Italian convertible roadster, a roadster that can't resist caressing the curves, a roadster that proves that when the top goes down, pulses go up.
Amore.
Subito.
No!
Mama loves Mambo. Mama loves Mambo. Look at him sway with it, getting so gay with it, shout no lay with it, wow. Papa loves Mambo.
Papa loves Mambo.
Mama loves Mambo.
Mama loves Mambo.
Papa does great with it, swing like a gay with it. And they're flaying again, younger than spring again.
Amore, siamo pronti!
Introducing the Italian Roadster, the all-new Fiat 124 Spider. When the top goes down, pulses go up.
Having their flaying again.
The Fiat 124 Spider has definitely been designed to turn you on. It represents the pinnacle of everything exciting about Fiat. But let's be clear, the Roadster is not a big segment. Spiders are driven by few. But fundamentally, we think that our potential is bigger than the segment. We believe we can appeal to the huge number of people who aspire to a car like this. People who have been on the fence, people who haven't dared to realize their dreams so far. These are people who generally are embracing a time of transition, a new sense of freedom. They are already sniffing around the web, so we will welcome them to embrace the bite of the spider. They are ready to convert, so we let them know that a convertible is not just a car that changes, but a car that changes you. To these dreamers, we'll dedicate a limited run of the first 124. So like this one here. It will be feature a never-to-be-repeated blue Italia paint scheme with saddle, interior, and all the premium amenities our Spider has to offer. Well, the 124 Spider will round out our big Italian family and deliver the promise we made to our studios that it will have fun Fiats, fast Fiats, bigger Fiats, and more capable Fiats. What you see on the stage today is literally history in the remaking. Well, let's wrap this. On one hand, you have Fiat 500X, a perfect primary car. On the other, you have a convertible roadster, which is not necessarily the ideal primary car, but both are Fiat, so there must be a primary source of fun, a primary source of pleasure, a primary expression of sheer driving enjoyment, because they have some things that you won't find everywhere else, the soul of Italy. You know, a Fiat is not Italian because we say it's Italian. It's not Italian because of a badge. It's Italian because of something that runs deeper than its Italian engine, speaks louder than a note of its tailpipe. It's not something we'll necessarily see or even hear. It's something that you can only feel. And that's the heart of everything Fiat. Thank you.
Members of the press, please hold for press photography. Thank you. Now please join Olivier for a closer look